Hey guys, Rescuer 942 here, and today we are welcome to another episode of Telly Story Time. And today we are going to be telling a story with the Telly Story Interactive Robux and my Jack Baby 2006. What is he, you ask? It's the Lion King. The Lion King in Simba's Pride. This is the Telly Story cartridge with the Lion King logo on it, so yeah. That's the cartridge. I'm going to insert it in the Telly Story. Open it up. There we go. Okay, you know what it looks like. So it's powered on and tell two complete stories. Jack Pacific. Handheld games. Disney. Tell a story!
Welcome to Disney.
Okay, first up, let's read the Lion King, because the narrator is too slow.
To have the
Let me read the narrator
Press
is too slow.
Button.
The hot African sun rose on an amazing sight. Giraffes, zebras, elephants, animals of all kinds were gathered on Pride Rock. This was an important day. King Mufasa and Queen Samari watched as Rafiki made the wise baboon presented their newborn son to the kingdom. The animals cheered and bowed before Prince Simba. But one family member did not attend the celebration with his brother, Scar. Scar was angry that he was no longer next in line to be king. Mufasa and his sister Zazu wanted to ask Scar why he had missed the presentation of Simba. Oh, it must have slipped my mind, Scar sneered as Andy walked away. Simba grew into a playful and curious cub. Early one morning, Mufasa brought Simba to the top of Pride Rock. Everything in the light touches is our kingdom, he told his son. One day, the sun will set. My time here will rise with you as the new king. Wow, cried Simba. Well, what about this shadowy place? That's beyond our borders. You must go there. You must never go there, Simba said. But I thought a king could do whatever he wants, said Simba, Mufasa explained. There's more to being king than getting your way all the time. You need to respect all creatures. We are all connected in the great circle of life. Simba tried to listen, but he was busy chasing grasshoppers and practicing his pounce. Just then, Zazu arrived with the important news. Hyenas has crossed into the Pride Lands. Mufasa ordered Zazu to take Simba home and ran off to battle hyenas. I never get to go anywhere, so I complained. Back at home, Simba wanted to see his uncle Scar. My dad has sold me the whole kingdom, the cub bragged. And I'm gonna rule it all. Did he show you that place beyond the border? Asked Scar slyly. One of the bravest lions would dare go to an elephant graveyard. Simba didn't see the uncle's evil trap. He died to tell his father what a brave cub he could be. Simba set out to find his best friend Nala. She was lying with their members on a rock nearby. Mom, can Nala and I go to the great place near the water hole? Fought Simba. As long as Zazu goes with you, answered Simba. We got to ditch Zazu, Simba whispered to Nala. We're really going to an elephant graveyard. Simba and Nala laughed as they ran in and out of the animal herd to escape from Zazu. We lost him, cried Nala. Together, they played, tumbling and rolling with a thump. They landed next to a huge elephant skull. Zazu caught up with them, but it was too late. Banzai, Zazu, and a free drooling hyenas with sharp teeth surrounded them. The hyenas grabbed Zazu first. Why don't you pick on somebody your own size? Asked Simba. The one tried to catch an elephant. Simba slapped his claws across the hyenas' cheek. Suddenly, a tremendous roar shook the ground. It was Mufasa. His giant paw struck one of the hyenas as he growled. If you ever come near my son again, hyenas ran away before he could finish. Mufasa scolded his son on his way home. You deliberately disobeyed me, Simba. I was just trying to be brave like you, Dad, said Simba softly. being brave doesn't mean you go looking for trouble, replied Mufasa. Then Mufasa told Simba how the kings of the past looked down on them from the stars above. There will always be their eye to guide you, and so will I. Scar was angry when the hyenas told him that Simba had escaped. But he quickly came up with a new plan to get rid of Simba and his father. I will be king, he cried. The next day, Scar found Simba. Your father will be has a marvelous surprise for you, he said. Scar led Simba down to a steep gorge and told him to wait there. Then Scar said, excited, looked around, he's right in the herd of wild beasts. They panicked, animals stampeded right towards Simba. Hearing the thunder of Hoos, Mufasa looked in the gorgeous eyes and he leaped down and saved Simba's life. Simba was safe, but Mufasa was still in danger. As he tried to climb away from the stamping, the rocks crumbled beneath him. Struggling up the cliff, Mufasa saw Scar. Brother, help me, he cried. Scar dug his sharp claws into Mufasa's spars and whispered, long live the king! Then Scar let Mufasa go and he disappeared beneath the herd below. Scar had seen only it that his father had fallen. When the stampede was gone, Simba ran to Mufasa. He tried to wake him, but the Lion King was dead. Help! Cried Simba. Scar came to Simba's side. If it weren't for you, he said, your father would be still alive. Run away, Simba, and never return. Heartbroken, poor Simba ran away as fast as he could. Scar sent the hyenas out to kill Simba, but the cub escaped from them once more. Scar was certain that Simba was dead. He went back to the Pride Rock and told everyone that it was a heavy heart. He lied, I become your new king. Everyone in the Pride Lands mourned for their king, their beloved King Simba. Meanwhile, Simba was far away from the Pride Lands. The ground grew dry and cracked beneath him. The odds let me down as vultures circled above his head. Exhausted and unable to go any further, Simba slumped to the ground. After a long while, Simba awoke. Everything around him looked different. There were trees and grass and flowers instead of desert. A meerkat named Simba and a warthog named Pumbaa have brought him to their home. You nearly died, said Pumbaa. We saved you, cried Simba. Thanking him, Simba stood up and started to leave. Pumbaa asked Simba where he was from, but Simba didn't want to answer. I did something terrible that I don't want to talk about it. You gotta put your past behind you, kid, said Timon. No past, no future, no worries, I'm gonna return it to Hakuna Matata. Simba decided to strangle with his new friends. Years passed and Simba grew into a young lion. One night, while looking at the stars, Simba remembered his father's words. Somebody once told me that the great kings of the past have been up there watching over us, he said to his friends. The next day, Pumbaa was chasing a bug with a furry lion springing him from the tall grass. He screamed and ran away, but got caught beneath the falls. It's gonna eat me, he squealed. Simba heard his friends' cries and rushed to help. Simba wrestled with the lioness, but then he realized he was his old friend Nala. You're alive, he said happily. That means you're a new king, Nala told Simba how Scar had destroyed the Pride Lands. Simba, if you don't do something, everyone will starve. I can't go back, said Simba angrily, and said he turned and walked away. Simba thought what Nala had said. I can't go back, he said to himself. It won't change anything. Just then, Simba heard a chanting sound from the jungle. Rakafi, the baboon, came walking toward him. If you want to see your father again, look rough, he said, pointing in the pool of water next to them. Simba saw the face of his father staring back at him. You see, said Rakafi, he lives in you. Now Simba looked up at his father's face in the stars and heard his voice. Look inside yourself, Simba. Remember what you are. You are my son and one true king. The next morning, Rakafi found Nala, Simba, and Pumbaa. He told them that Simba had returned to the Pride Lands. He's got back to challenge Scar, cheered Nala. When Simba reached bright lights, he was sad by what he saw. His home was that once green and beautiful as her bed had buried under Scar's rule. Very bravely, Simba continued on his journey. When Simba arrived at Pride Rock, he let out a roar that shook the earth. Scar was surprised and frightened. He fought the hyenas who had killed Simba long ago. "This is my kingdom," shouted Simba. "Step down, Scar." Scar ordered his hyenas to attack. They surrounded Simba and drove him to the edge of the cliff. Simba grabbed onto the rocks with his claws as Scar stood above him. That's just the way your father looked before he died," snarled Scar. But Simba realized that it had been Scar who killed his father. With new strength, Simba launched onto the rock and attacked. At the moment, Nala, Timon, and Pumbaa arrived, and a battle broke out on Pride Rock. This time, Simba strapped Scar to the steep edge of Pride Rock. Sparing his life, he ordered his uncle to run away and never return. Scar pretended to leave, but then turned and lunged down at Simba. Simba swiped at Scar, causing him to fall to the hyenas below. Scar was never heard from again. Simba took his rightful place at the Lion King, and once more the land flourished. Soon all the animals scattered at Pride Rock to celebrate the birth of Simba and Nala's cub.